Well, hello. So I thought I would do a video which would kind of go over how the van is doing after 4 months. 4 months living in the van full-time, RV camping. It's gone through the ringer, and this is what I think about it so far. First off, the van, fantastic. I can't think of anything I would change on it. Again, it's a Dodge Ram 3500, extended body, ProMaster, all that stuff. It worked really good. It's got like 6 or 7,000 miles on it now. So I'll just show you around.
So I covered the windows with this Reflectix. Now the trick on that is I just shove it up underneath this just rubber here. So what I did is I cut out a 1 liter Coke bottle and then I just stapled it to the... Now it's a kind of a challenge to cut it out, but just take your time and you'll get a nice good fit. So I do it here, and then one or two in here. You got to where it just flies out. I did that. Now you don't need to do it on the front window. That does take time to cut that out too. I bought this stuff at Home Depot, and it's got to be in like the 4 foot wide rolls. The 3 foot wide rolls won't do it. Nothing to talk about in here. It's all perfect. So the step has been perfect all summer long. Worked great. You gotta have something there. Vinyl flooring has been perfect. Now, I would caution you to not go to Home Depot or Lowe's to get kind of a residential grade. You want to get like a commercial grade vinyl, something, you know, you don't use a whole big bunch of it, but it's gotta be tough to, I mean, man, there's just like dirt and grit and that all gets tracked inside of there. And if it's cheap, it's just gonna fall apart. So what's that? That is an air conditioner. So boy, right about July, man, it was like 90 degrees. And boy, you'd be dying in the van. Now, when we were in an RV park and we had shore power, that was amazing. Now, it does need to be vented out somewhere. So it comes with a hose that we store in the back. I was just running it out this window and I cut a little hole in the Reflectix right there and then kind of ran the glass up to it. And that worked good. I'm thinking about on the other side of this, maybe putting a hole. Boy, it's like a 6-inch hole. It's a 6-inch duct that goes to that. So that'd be a pretty big hole. And boy, I'm putting that off. Cutting a 6-inch hole in a brand new van, you know, it was as bad as cutting a big hole up in there. I thought about doing a rooftop one, but as you can see, it's getting kind of snug up there with all of the solar panels and the roof vent. So that might be a challenge to kind of squeeze that up in there somewhere up in here or here. And the more you put up in the roof, the worse the gas mileage is going to get. You know, you got to weigh all that stuff. This is it's like a medium powered AC, and that cools the van down pretty good. So the lights have worked great. I mean, they dim, you know, goes on and off. I like that. Everything in the solar has worked fantastic. Nothing to even talk about. It's perfect. It works every time, all the time, anytime. The fridge is perfect. I don't know what I would change. You know, it's not as good as those big Class A fridges, but boy, I don't have the power for that. The only thing is that, you know, the freezer part there will frost up. I mean, you can't help that. It's got this little cover, but it cleans pretty easily. We used the baskets for a while and got rid of those. I did have a little temperature gauge right here, but you know, you can tell when the food's just like ice cold, and that's frosty. It's going to be good enough. So the thing barely uses power. I really think you could probably use this with a single 12 volt battery, and I think it would probably work okay. The TV, boy, what is this? It's a Access. The remote is real goofy. I mean, where is even the eject button? It's made in Korea or something, but so I don't know. It's got a sound bar. I like that. but I think if I had to do it over again, I'm gonna take and put in like a regular just Blu-ray here, and then tie that up into a real, like a Sony screen, and maybe buy a little sound kit for the Sony. Yeah, it's just we watch TV at night and it's nice, and it's just kind of, what was it, $160 for everything? So it's, you know, it's just beyond cheap. So yeah, I think I'm gonna try to do that. So the fan ran, God, how many hours? 8 hours a night times 4 months. I think I'm gonna try, and it does fit underneath there real well. I think I'm gonna try to do something like, I'm gonna try to mount it on this guy here so that it can kind of just swivel. If it's down here, then it's like it doesn't get up high enough, so you have to end up putting like books or something to get it up so that it blows air down on us. Yes, that is the benefit of putting the vent fan right there, but I've got lots of solar panels there. I don't like the solar panels to go up front because there's a lot of wind load in the very front, and I'm afraid that one of them would just rip off. That has happened on videos. I've seen guys who had their front panel torn off. So, man, that would be a bummer. So I'm going to try to kind of play with this to flip it and to mount it underneath here so it can just swivel. I am going to transfer all these onto a hard drive. Books, yeah, that's nice. The little lights have worked great the entire time. Never a flaw, works fantastic. The drawers are good if there's not really big things inside. So I had to put some of these latches on the drawers that have like more than 10 pounds. This one here has at least 20 pounds in it. So the poles have about maybe a 5 pound pole. You know, they're just automatic closure, so they do close nice. But they won't hold more than like a 10 pound before when you go around a turn, it'll come out. What else? Fantastic fan has been fantastic. That's the clever name. Microwave has been great. It's just a cheapy Farberware. It works perfectly. Doesn't draw just too much power. The Coleman stove cabinet has been fine. Nothing to talk about there. Redwood I was a little cautious about because it is a real soft wood, but it just has been fine. It's basically bulletproof. You really don't bang that wood that much, but it's so light too that it's a really nice thing to have inside of a van. And it does stain up really prettily. And this little shelf has just been great. We put it's the same. I put a little light here, put my car keys, sunglasses, remotes. That's a must. The wood paneling has been great. Nothing to talk about there. That stuff's it's nice and light. It's pretty. I like it. The induction has been fantastic. Works perfect. Doesn't draw too much power. I don't know what I changed about that. Never have used a sink. Never needed it. We always take the dishes out. You know, there's usually like a water spigot or something, and we clean the dishes off before, and then we just rinse them off outside and bring them back in. I don't really want to change gray water and mess with all that and lugging it out. These things are not light water containers. So that's our basic junk drawer, trash, little paper towels. The wine cabinet has worked fantastic. I have this little drawer or latch, and then it's just worked great. And again, it's a step for to get into the bed. The Fiamma Eagle 65S motorized awning. It goes in and goes out great. That's not the problem. When the problem is when it's all the way out and there's any kind of breeze, it'll go back in. It's got a just automatic retract so that it won't get torn off in a windstorm. That's good, but even all the way dialed to its minimum, it's still a little too touchy. If there's just a little breeze, it'll go in. So it's like, I think if I had to do it over again, I'd bag the motor. It was a pay a bear to run all that wiring anyway. Just use the little hand crank. And then they do make these little struts that go from here and they tie into there that really hold that just awning still in the wind. I think that would have been better. I think if I had to do it again, I would not do the motorized awning. But, you know, it is choice. So, yeah. The solars work great. Nothing to talk about there. I mean, they're just bulletproof. My little drawers have worked perfectly. Nothing to talk about there. Again, all the electronics have been perfect. Oh, and here's that vent for the AC unit. So it does fold down into a pretty small unit, and this just goes into the window itself. You know, if I had to do it over again, I would get a lot more finicky about this roof. Not so much the stuff, but if there's the least little bit of crack, I stare at it. Because you're laying in bed looking up. So then you're going, God, why didn't I just push that over a little bit? Or if I would have just taken a little bit more time, you know, you can kind of get in a big rush and you don't want to take too long doing it. So little things like that. There's another little crack. And you know, when you're laying in bed, you're just looking up at it going, why didn't I? So if you're going to do this kind of roof, take your time with it. I mean, make sure every board is nice and snug in there. I tried to hide the nails in the seams. I wouldn't do that again. You know, they're not falling down, but it's just too much work. I just put maybe three in per right in the middle, you know, just right there, and right there. You can maybe put a little dab of just liquid nails where you're going to nail along there. It would never come down, and you have to use some putty then to fill those little holes with, but you still have to use putty to fill the holes in the cracks, and it's really hard to sand the cracks. So I don't think I would do that again, but I would get a lot more fussy and take my time on this whole roof part. The lights have worked fantastic. I mean, they can dim all the way down to just a red light. There was some talk that the Midnight Solar Turbo, the way it cools is a fan, and some people were concerned about that. I've never heard it run. When you sleep right by things, it can be a problem, but it's not really been a big deal.
So that's been my update of this 2017 Dodge ProMaster conversion van that I did. I would probably use another ProMaster. If I built another one, I probably will. Who are we kidding? maybe not this year, maybe next year or the year after that. I would probably do pretty much the same thing, except for the little points that I talked about. And I don't know that I would ever add a bathroom or a shower. I don't know that I'd ever add running water into it. You know, if I want those things, I'll go out and buy a Travato. You know, maybe like a 2 or 3 year old one that's got it all. So, and then, or a Class A, you know, that way you got tons of room and you got a shower and all that stuff. But it's just not worth it for what I need for right now. So I hope you've enjoyed that, and I'll see you later.